anyway, I started getting nervous. I'm like, I'm going to meet God in just a minute. I don't even know how to greet God. Do I shake hands or do I curtsy or bow or, I mean, do we hug? I feel close enough to God to hug God, but I know a lot of people want to hug me because TV does that, but I don't want to hug a lot of these people. So just trying to be respectful. So anyway, a couple minutes later, God walks in the room carrying the tray of fondue and Chablis. I would say she was about 47, 48 years old. Just beautiful, beautiful black woman. And we just immediately hugged, and oh, she smelled so good. She said it was Calvin Klein's obsession. And we sat down and started drinking the Chablis and talking about the weather and what was going to happen to it. And I was asking just different questions, a bunch of questions I was just curious about. Like I said, like, what's the hardest thing about being God? And she said, trusting people. You never know if people really like you or if it's just because you're God. And people always want something from you. They want money, and then they want more money. That's what they ask for a lot. Nobody ever thanks her anymore. Only people who thank her are boxers and rappers. Yeah. Yeah. Rappers are singing songs like, slap the bitch up the ass. I'd like to thank the Lord Almighty for this award. Praise Jesus. Nobody cares about the miracles anymore. The miracles just go by unnoticed. I said, what was the last miracle? And she cried. She was upset that I had to ask. It's the toilet that flushes automatically. Yep. 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 Before that, it was the George Foreman grill because the fat just strips right off. And, yeah. So anyway, I guess it was the Chablis or something, but I loosened up enough to say, I said, God, I have to admit, I really felt alone a lot. I felt like you didn't exist. I didn't believe in you for a time. And she said, do you remember that day you were walking on the beach? I said, yeah. She said, I was there. I said, there was just one set of footprints, though. She said, I was on your back. I thought I felt heavy that day. I thought it was water retention. She said, know that when you are bloated, I am there. That comforts me. You know, I'm not going to bore you with everything. We talked about a lot of stuff. I mean, she told me the meaning of life and stuff like that. But anyway, I was leaving, I was walking out the door, and I turned around and I said, God, I have to say I'm sorry. I am so sorry that we're killing all the animals. I'm so sorry that we're chopping down all the trees. I'm sorry that we're filled with hate instead of love. I'm sorry that we call each other names and judge each other. I'm sorry that we go to war and kill each other. I'm sorry. And she was silent for a few seconds, and then she looked at me and she said, have you seen Gloria Estefan's hair lately?
Textbook.
I'm in your college textbook?
Yeah. It says that you are a role model instead of the people on Melrose.
In your college textbook, I'm a role model? In your...
I have it here.
Wow. Are you giving this to me? You're just showing me? I trust you. You don't have to, you know. Liar!
I come from France. I saw you. I saw you on French TV. You speak in French.
I did.
Yeah.
Was I muy bueno?
First of all, I want to say I saw you in the Stola Center. Do you remember that?
Where? You saw me where?
In the Stola Center in Stony Brook years ago when you first started. I saw you. Oh, come on. Oh, I have your picture.
Oh, yeah, there you are. Yeah, how have you been?
Great.
Look at you. How do you pronounce your name again?
Arlene.
Arlene, yeah, yeah. You look fantastic. Have you lost a little weight or something? I didn't even recognize you.
It's God. No, I'm kidding.
I wanted to ask you, Eleanor, you and Anne are thinking of having a commitment ceremony. I'd like to be invited to that.
Oh, well, just jot down your name. We'll definitely invite you. Absolutely. Yes, ma'am.
I am a rabbi, and I will do your wedding, yours and Anne's wedding for you.
You'll do our wedding?
Yes.
All right, and she'll come. Fantastic. It's all set. Do we have a caterer in the audience? Super. We would like finger sandwiches, please. Yes, sir, right there. Yep.
Ma'am,
sorry, I'm sorry. See. No, the man behind you. Yes, ma'am. My princess, talk to me. Oh, queen of mine.
I actually just had a comment. You were a role model to me both before and especially after you came out. Excuse me, I'm sorry. And I just want to thank so much you and your wife, Anne, for coming out because it took so much strength and courage, and you give me so much hope and promise for my future that I can be normal and fulfill my dreams. And I'm one of the people that you changed my life by coming out, and I'm living proof, so thank you.
And love each other. Good night. Thank you so much for coming out. I appreciate it.